So if you're looking to use your brand new A7S III or maybe an A7 III or maybe any Sony camera for that matter, you want to improve your webcam quality and use this camera instead of your webcam, Sony just made it incredibly easy and I want to show you how. So let's get right into it. All you need to make this happen is a USB-C cable if you're using a Mac and USB-C straight into the computer and it works flawlessly if you have the right software. So let's dive right into the computer. I'll show you how to do this in three simple steps. So first things first, you're gonna click the link in the description down below and it's gonna take you right to this website, the Sony Imaging Edge webcam software. All you have to do is choose whatever models that you wanna use. It basically will tell you which ones are confirmed to work with it. Choose your model, hit download, whether you're a Windows user or a Mac user, it works the same way, which is fantastic. I'm using a Mac, so I will go ahead and click the Mac software. It'll make you restart your computer and then you're good to go. The second thing you're gonna wanna make sure of is that you just go into your camera settings, into the transfer remote section. You wanna make sure that you have control with smartphone off and the PC remote function on and PC remote connect method USB. That's it. You don't have to change anything else in your camera. Choose the picture profile you want, doesn't matter. That's all you have to do on the camera. After you've installed the software, you don't have to go looking for the application that you just installed. That's what I did when I first installed it, but there's not actually an application that runs for it. It just now shows up in all the softwares that you want to use as a webcam. So all you have to do is take your USB-C cable, plug it right into the camera, plug it right into the computer, turn on your camera. On the camera, you will notice right below the actual frame rate that you're shooting, and you'll see a PC thing now illuminated in yellow. That basically just means that it's connected to the computer, which is what you want. Then all you have to do is open up your favorite application that you normally would use, whether it be Zoom or Ecamm Live or straight into Facebook or YouTube. And you'll notice that if you go to preferences, when you go to video, you now see that you have the option for Sony Camera Imaging Edge. So right when you select Sony Camera Imaging Edge, you now see that, hey. The great thing about it is because it just shows up like a webcam, whether you're using a software like Zoom, or you're using a software like Ecamm Live, it works the exact same way and you can use the camera for no matter what source you want to use. The great thing is also, even when you are using it as a webcam, you still can record to the camera like you normally would. If I go ahead and hit record, it will just record like it has a normal SD card in it, but you can still use it with all its functionality, change all the settings, everything you want directly on the camera, and so it works really, really well. Another really great feature of the Sony is the fact that since you can power your camera from USB, while you are using it as a webcam, it is actually charging at all times, which is awesome because unlike the Canon that I used to use for a webcam, I had to have a separate battery charging ready to go when that one went dead. This will just charge at all times while you're using it, which Sony, that's incredible. One very important thing to note is that audio does not pass through USB-C. So when you are using it for Ecamm Live or Zoom or whatever purpose you're actually using it for, you still have to select an audio source to be able to actually use as audio. That's very important because even if you have a mic on here, the audio is not passing through USB-C. So you'll notice how in Zoom, when I go to my audio settings and I go to microphone, I still don't get the option to choose that camera because audio doesn't work that way. So you still have to have some sort of interface, or if you want to use the built-in webcam microphone on your computer, or what I tend to do that actually works really well is I will use my other Rode mic, which is actually a USB-based microphone, and then I can use that as the actual audio interface while I can use this as my actual webcam. If I'm at my home studio and I have an actual audio interface, I'll select the interface instead of the camera, but very important to notice because you may think that you have this perfect setup here, but you don't realize that the people watching you on it are hearing whatever your built-in microphone settings are. So choose the right one. And that's how easy it is to use your Sony camera as your webcam. You're welcome. Thanks for watching.